of the blue of the western sky comes Sky King. As we say here in the West, streak, partner.
Reach for Nabisco.
Partner!
Reach for Nabisco.
The bright red seal on the package end
means there's mighty good cookies inside,
my friend.
Yep, that famous Nabisco seal is on all your favorite cookies. Creamy chocolatey Oreo cream sandwich. Yummy Fig Newtons. Mouth-melting Lorna Doone. Chipperoons, those great-tasting coconut chocolate drop cookies. And many, many others. So just remember, when it comes to cookies,
reach for Nabisco.
Nabisco!
And now, Sky King.
Doubtful pass. Me a cracking my black snake whip over my Bronx. And the Indians was a gaining on the stagecoach all the time. Zing!
There went an arrow.
Right beside my ear. And bang! There went another bullet. Right in the wood beside me.
Well, then what happened, Pop?
Did you take out your six guns and...
No.
Well, tell us, Pop, what'd you do?
Well, we didn't do nothing.
Oh, nothing. What happened?
Well, you see, the Indians, they caught up with us.
Yes, and what happened then?
What? Nothing happened. They just scalped us all.
Oh, Pop, was that nice?
Now don't let Pop kid you. He's had some real experiences.
Oh, shucks, son. I ain't done anything more than anybody else.
Oh, don't be so modest, Pop. You know, if the people of Brover didn't respect you and what you did to help develop the West, why, they wouldn't keep picking you to lead the Frontier Days parade every year.
And without you leading the parade, it wouldn't be a parade. Well, you're a Grover tradition, Pop.
Oh, say, Sky, I'm so awful sorry about you flying at night. But I'm mighty grateful for you coming up there to my little mine and picking me up. And by George, the next time, I'm going to remember where I put my black snake whip.
Don't worry about it, Pop. We'll still get into Grover in plenty of time for a good night's sleep.
Isn't tomorrow the 30th anniversary of the last time you drove the express stage over the Indian Flats run?
Yeah. Then after that last trip, they retired the old stage to the Grover Museum. And now they just take it out once a year, and that's for the Frontier Days celebration.
Say, why couldn't Pop make this a sort of an anniversary, leading the old stagecoach in the parade? And I could ride along as passenger.
Leave it to Penny to get into the act.
Clipper.
Don't let Clipper tease you, Penny. I think it's a fine idea. Don't you, Pop?
Well, Sky, I reckon you're right.
I'm sure the parade committee will, too, when we tell them about it.
Gee.
Should have been here 20 minutes ago.
Well, you didn't want anyone to see us come in here, did you? They might think it kind of funny to trust the express agent with having such late visitors.
Yeah, especially when he's got a $100,000 gold shipment in his safe.
All right. Let's get to work. You two, move those filing cabinets away from the door. Here's the key to the door.
Maybe that strong box must really weigh a lot, huh?
Yeah, it does. It's 200 pounds of gold in it. And the box weighs another 100.
Now, I know why you said we couldn't carry it out of here.
You couldn't get it 50 feet without somebody spotting it and giving the alarm.
Why, it'd take us half the night and enough pounding to wake the dead to bust that thing open.
You know, when I first heard your scheme, I thought it was crazy, but now it's making more and more sense.
After working for the same company on the same job in the same room for 12 years, don't you think I can figure out a perfect plan? Now let's get that box of gold out of here.
Think so?
I'll try it, see if it works.
There you are.
Yeah, that safe looks like it's really been busted open.
Yeah. Here. Tie me good and tight so I have to struggle to get loose.
Oh, sure, I'll do a good job. Give me a hand. Try your feet.
I'll wait about half an hour. Then I'll break loose and give the alarm.
You got all your tools gathered up?
Yeah, I'm all set.
You better see if the coast is clear.
Okay.
It's all clear.
See you tomorrow, Bowling. Fingerprints, did you?
Certainly not. What do you think, I'm stupid?
Good. It all happened so fast, Sheriff.
Did you recognize any of them?
No. No, they all wore masks. When I went to the door, one of them stuck a gun in my face. Then they ordered me to open the safe. I refused, and they slugged me. When I came to, they were gone, and I was tied up. Took me about a half hour to get loose.
Well, that's not much to go on. How many of them were there?
Three.
I'm afraid this is going to be like looking for a needle in a haystack. There's so many strangers in Grover for the Frontier Day celebration. Briggs, send out an alarm for three men in a strong box, weighing about...
About 300 pounds.
All right, Sheriff.
Yeah, they used an electric drill. Guess they weren't figuring on your opening the safe for them, Whit.
After 12 years as an express agent, this has to happen to me.
I know how you feel.
Yeah, but by tomorrow, that strong box would have been on its way east.
It wasn't your fault. Now, I guess we'd better have the doctor take a look at that bump on your head. I'll take you over.
No, never mind, Sheriff. I'll be all right.
Well, then I'll lock up for you.
Oh, thanks. I'll see you in the morning. Good night.
Good night.
You know, Miss Penny, you're one of the prettiest passengers I ever drove stage for.
Oh, Pop, you're just joshing me with a bit of your blarney.
Typical Arizona cowgirl.
Oh, now, Clipper, you know you're pretty proud that Penny's going to be riding in the celebration with Pop.
Morning, King. Morning.
Morning.
Hey, what's this I hear about Pop Riley driving the stage in the parade today instead of Matt Guthrie?
Well, Mr. Bowling, since today is the 30th anniversary of Pop making the last express run, we thought it might be a nice idea for him to lead the parade driving the old stage.
Oh.
And the entertainment committee thought so, too.
Well, do you think Pop can handle the horses with all this noise and excitement?
You mean to insinuate that I'm too old? Listen, son, I drove stage before you was born.
Mr. Bowling, I think Pop will be able to handle it all right.
Well, since the express company doesn't own the stage anymore, the entertainment committee has a right to pick who drives it. See you all later.
Well, come on, Penny.
Take care.
Keep going.
See you at the rodeo.
You bet.
Okay.
So long, Howard.
Well, did you fix it so I'd be driving the stage like we planned?
No. They got the entertainment committee to say that Pop Riley was to drive us.
Pop Riley?
Yeah.
But if that stage reaches the fairground, some nosy person's liable to find the gold.
I know that. That's why you're going to ride out to where Rowan and Kirk were to meet you. And this is what you're going to tell them to do.
We didn't get here any too soon.
Let's get ready.
Say, what's the matter with you, Mavericks? You nearly made me have a runaway.
Don't you know the celebration doesn't start until this afternoon?
Shut up, you two, and nothing will happen to you. You drive the stage. Get back in there. I said get back in there.
If this is some kind of a joke, I don't think it's very funny.
No, this isn't a joke. Now get in there and shut up.
Wait a minute, you ornery sidewind coyote.
Look, I don't like hitting old men like you, but in your case, I'll make an exception. Now get in there and shut up.
Listen here. I want to take...
Attention. Attention, please. Pop Riley, driving the old Concord Express stage, seems to have been delayed. Rather than keep you waiting any longer, we'll start the grand entrance right away. Better go, boys.
I just don't understand it. Pop left town long before we did.
Here comes Briggs now. Maybe he's got some news. Well?
Radio car went over the back road, Sheriff. They couldn't find the stagecoach.
Sky, it just doesn't make sense.
Let's mount up. We'll have a look. Come on, Clipper.
I don't see how a stagecoach could have just disappeared into nothing.
Neither do I, Clipper. If it was broken down along the way, we'd have found it.
It's just as if the earth had opened up and swallowed it.
Well, with Penny and Pop right along with it.
I wonder if there could be any connection between the express holdup last night and the stagecoach disappearing.
What would a bunch of robbers want with an old stagecoach?
I don't know, Sheriff.
It'll take us days to search every canyon and draw around here on horseback.
And that's why Clipper and I are heading back for the ranch in the Songbird.
Oh, this is the craziest thing I ever heard of. Stealing a 75-year-old stagecoach.
Maybe you think Sky King is the only one around here with any brains.
You'll think so, too, when he catches up with you.
Why don't you take off your mask? You'd be much more comfortable.
You mean so you can give my description to the police?
Cut the gab and give us a hand in here.
Right. Now, don't you two run away.
Sky will take care of that smart aleck.
Yeah.
Flown over nearly every gully and canyon in the country.
There's another one up ahead there. The stage was on a road somewhere. We'd have spotted it. It's got to be under some kind of cover.
Well, if it is, we haven't got a chance of finding it from the air.
I don't know, Clipper, but we can't give up trying.
what's going on in there?
Run, Penny, run!
Don't be trigger happy. She can't get far on foot. Besides, someone might hear the shot. You stay here and tie him up again. We'll go after the girl.
Come on.
There she goes.
See anything?
Not a thing.
Look, Flipper.
Hey, it's an X.
I think we found Pop and Penny, maybe the missing stagecoach.
What do we do now?
We're going to land over there behind that hill and see what needs to be done.
We're going on up to the house. You stay here. Come on.
Right.
You were pretty smart, didn't you, trying to get away?
You just wait until my Uncle Sky gets here.
Oh, so you think your wonderful Sky King is going to come and save you? Well, he'll have to find you first, and he'll have a hard time doing that. Well, it'll be days before he finds that old stagecoach. By then, we'll be gone.
You all right, Penny?
Oh, Sky, you saw it.
You bet we did.
Are you okay, Pop?
Takes more than a little crack on the head to finish Pop Riley.
Oh, boy. Hey, that was pretty smart of you, tramping down the plants in that field that way.
They thought I was trying to dodge them. From where they stood, they couldn't tell what I was doing.
Hey, what are we going to do with him?
First, we'll find out who he is.
Hey, look, it's Man Guthrie. He's the guy that was supposed to drive the stage in the parade today.
Well, why would he want to hijack the stage?
I don't know, Penny. You better tie him up.
That'll be a pleasure.
Now, what happened, Penny?
Well, three men with guns stopped us and brought us here and tied us up.
Do you know where the other two men are?
I heard them say they were going up to the house.
Do you recognize either one of them?
Well, they all wore masks.
We better get the sheriff.
Hey, we can use the stagecoach to get us back to town.
Right, Pop. Come on. Take a look up there. The stage is too high to get through the doorway.
Too high?
That don't make sense.
I think there's a fairly simple explanation for it. When this coach was pulled in here, someone was in it. The weight of a man or two would push the springs down far enough so they could get it through the doorway.
But there wasn't anybody in it, Sky.
No one? You sure, Penny?
She's right. It was empty, the same as it is now.
Yet they got it through the doorway.
Well, unless the barn shrunk or the stagecoach grew, it's impossible.
There's one other possibility. And if I'm right, there's a lot of things beginning to make sense now.
What do you mean, Sky?
I'll tell you after I talk to those other two men. You say they went up the house?
Well, I think so.
Just a minute, Sky. I'm going with you. I got a little score to settle with them two fellers myself.
All right, Pop. We'll do it together. Flipper, I want you and Penny to take the stagecoach horses and ride for the sheriff.
Roger.
Now get going. Come on, Pop.
Come in.
Office.
Well, Pop,
should wait for the sheriff.
And let him get away with all that gold. Look, there's two of them, and there's two of us. That makes it more than even.
All right, Pop.
How long would keep him going?
Oh, don't worry. He'll be here in time to grab his share of the gold.
Tie your hands. Move away from that box.
Strong box from the express company, all right.
Right, Pop. They were pretty clever.
Drop your guns, both of you.
Now all the pieces fit into place.
Well, Mr. Schuyler King, you think you know everything. But do you know what it's like to handle money, a lot of money, and not be able to touch it because it isn't yours? Well, I do. But it's not going to be like that any longer.
You'll never get away with it, Bowling.
Why not? All I've got to do is take care of you and your nosy friend.
Sure. You can take care of us, but you'll never move your gold out.
What makes you think so?
Because by now, Penny and Clipper have reached Grover, and the sheriff will be having all the roads watched.
All right, King, then you can fly us out. Yes, I saw your plane the other side of the ridge. You can fly us to a little shack on Mugyon Mesa.
And if I refuse?
You got your choice.
I see what you mean.
I thought you would. Both of you grab that strong box and bring it along. And don't try anything because I'm keeping you covered.
What are you going to do about him?
Leave him. You want less to be in on the split.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Hurry up.
You can start looking for a landing spot, King.
That looks like a pretty fair spot over there.
Okay, bring her down. What you doing?
Switching gas tanks. You wouldn't want to run out of gas up here, would you?
What's the matter?
The landing gear's stuck. It won't release.
What are you trying to pull, King?
Try it yourself.
If this is some trick, I
must be jammed or broken somewhere.
Right, the wheels ain't coming down. What are you gonna do?
If we can't land with wheels, we'll land without them. Take her down, King.
A belly landing on this rocky ground?
Why not?
The second the plane touched, the friction would send the sparks flying. With the gas tanks ripped open.
I don't want to be blown up all over Arizona.
Shut up. Where can we land?
Only at an airport where there's a smooth runway and a crash truck to meet us in a hurry.
But we can't unload the gold there.
Take your choice. Save the gold or your skin.
We'll take our chances with you landing us here. Take her down, King.
I said take her down.
There's just a chance I can land this ship without all of us being killed. I'm going to try to shake the landing gear loose.
How can you do that?
By putting the plane in a steep dive and then bringing it out. It might bring the wheels down.
All right. Try it.
I guess we can head back for Grover now.
Yeah, you better radio in to have a crash truck meet us when we get there.
I don't think we'll need it.
Yeah, but you said the landing gear was stuck.
I pulled the lead wire off the landing gear motor when I switched fuel tanks. I can roll the wheels down with the emergency hand crank.
Well, Sky, did you have to be so doggone convincing?
Museum next door where the old stagecoach was kept. It was easy.
Yeah, they just took the gold out of the safe and put it under the seat of the coach.
Then when the stagecoach was brought out for the celebration, one of the men was to drive it out of town where the gold was to be unloaded. But with Pop driving the stage, they had to change their plans.
Oh.
Yeah, that's why the sidewinders came after Penny and me, huh?
How'd you figure it all out, Sky?
Well, Sheriff, the tip-off was out at the barn when the stage was too high to go through the doorway.
And you figured it must have been something heavy to weigh down the springs, like 200 pounds of gold, huh?
That's about it, Sheriff. Say, it's getting late. Pop's going to lead that grand march tonight. We've got to get that stagecoach out the fairgrounds.
It's already out there, Sky. And just plain Pop Riley isn't going to lead the parade tonight. It's going to be Deputy Sheriff Pop Riley.
Well, but it was Sky.
Now, Pop, you did more than your share. And with you on the job, I'm sure we've seen the last of the stagecoach robbers.
Yeah, but you thought you...